Okay, so I have this awesome image here. By the way, nice model, nice pose. Link to the photo in the description, and the first step is to open the tone curve panel. Also, just to make some more space, I will hit F6 and F7 to hide the panels at the bottom and left side of the screen. For this photo, we will use this panel right here, which shows a histogram in the back, and we will also use the channels RGB, red, green, and blue. If you don't see these color channels, it means you're not in the point curve editor and you see these sliders right here. So you need to click on this icon which says click to edit point curve, and here you go, you can see the channels now. Let's start by creating some contrast in this photo and understand how this panel works. You have this straight line here, and this means that the photo is not affected at all by this tool. If you add a point and drag it up or down, you will still see this dotted line. When you move any point that you added above the dotted line, that means you increase value. And because we are on the RGB channel, it means we are increasing the brightness in the photo. On the opposite, if we are dragging it under the dotted line, it means we are decreasing the value. In this case, the value of the brightness. So we are darkening the photo. To make it more simple than this, imagine two triangles. If you add and drag points in triangle number one, you will increase values. And if you drag any point in triangle number two, you will decrease values. Here's a quick tip when you're adding points on this line in Lightroom. Sometimes it's hard to click exactly on this line and you end up modifying the value of that point, and maybe you don't want that. Just press down Alt or Option and then click to add a point. This way the point is added without modifying its value in the same time. When I want to add contrast, I usually stick to an S curve because it looks like the letter S, but first I add 3 points, in the whites, midtones, and darks. And of course I'm holding down Alt or Option when doing this. And here comes the second quick tip for you. When you want to simply move a point and be more precise, you can hold down Alt or Option while dragging it, and the point will move much slower, so you can choose the desired position for it more easily. So I will take this point and raise its value to increase the brightness of the photo. Because I added this point here in the midtones, the darks and shadows are protected and they will not be affected by this step. I created an isolation between the midtones and the highlights, and when I brighten up the image, this affects only some of the midtones, whites, and highlights. Next step is to darken the shadows area a bit more, because this is the way to increase contrast in the image. You pull up the highlights and you dial down the shadows. So I'm going to grab this point and drag it down, not too much. This is something personal. You can create soft contrast, medium, or strong contrast. It's up to you. I will stop somewhere around this point. I also want to create that kind of faded blacks, and I have a very good area on this image to demonstrate this. Let me zoom in here. And you can see this area, which is already very dark, but I want to lift up the blacks. And I can do this by grabbing this point and pushing it upwards. You can see how some of the pixels are losing details here, but in the same time, if you look at the whole image, it really gives you that moody vintage kind of feel, and this is something I'm usually into. It's not necessary when color toning or grading, but I love it. Like I said before in my other videos, it's more of a personal choice when pushing sliders or control points here in Lightroom. If you want to check a before and after, you can use the backslash key for this. I didn't touch any color until this point, but as you can see, the difference from the original is big. Here is an important tip that I want to share if you want to lift up the blacks. Do not push this point higher than the following point here, because if you do this, your blacks will look very weird. So you should imagine a horizontal line here. Do not cross it when lifting blacks. I think we are good with the contrast for now. Let's start shifting some colors here. And to be able to color grade with curves, you need to understand how colors work. If you look at the RGB complementary colors, you'll find something like this. In Lightroom's curves panel, we have red, green, and blue. So you need to learn the following. The opposite of red is cyan. The opposite of green is magenta, and the opposite of blue is yellow. The same thing happens here. Let's choose the red channel. When we create a point here and push it above the dotted line, it will insert red. And if we drag it under the dotted line, it will insert the opposite, in this case, cyan. Let's choose the green now. Push it up to insert green, drag it below the line to insert magenta. And the last one, the blue channel, push it upwards to add blue, drag it down to add yellow. It's very simple when you start to understand it. And now, let's start playing with all the three channels. I will start with red. I create 3 points, just like I did on the RGB channel. I want to add some red in the shadows area, so I grab this point right here and push it above the dotted line. And you can see that I added red in the shadows. I will also grab the midtones control point and drag it down to insert just a bit of cyan there. All these point movements need to be very subtle. They will make a big difference in the end. Don't forget about the before and after to check the results. Hit the backslash key for that. And now let's move to the green channel. Again, adding 3 points on this line for a better control. You can add more than 3 points for a better isolation of the areas that you want to affect. So I will take this point and drag it down to add the opposite of the green, which is magenta. Again, very small movement. We don't want to overdo things here. And finally, let's move to the blue channel. Add the same 3 points on this line. And this time, I want to warm up the bright parts of the image. So I grab this point and drag it below the dotted line to add some yellow. Also, I would like to add some blue color into the shadows. So I select this control point and pull it up until I start to see some blue tones in the image. I can use the faded shadows technique for the blue channel as well, so I grab this point and push it up to about 9 or 10%. Let's check the before and after using the backslash key again. Look at this huge difference from the original, it's amazing. Of course, I can't stop here, so I will go to the effects tab here to add a soft vignette. I will choose a minus 10 value for this. And also, I insert some grain, 50 for the amount, 30 for the size, and 50 for roughness. If you think the photo is too saturated, you can go up here to the basic settings and lower the saturation value with a few steps. It depends on what style you want to achieve. So this is an example of how you can color grade a photo using the tone curve in Lightroom. In my opinion, it's not too hard as soon as you understand the tool and how colors work.